Okay. I don't think I've talked to her.
If you want to stay under the radar, I've got just the thing.
Miss Jasmine with ship services.
So, looks like we got ourselves a new rook. Once again, I'm Jazz, resident engineer here. Like Neva said, you need ship parts, repairs? I'll hook you up. As long as your credits are good.
Let's just say once again, I'm Jazz. She didn't say it before. Jazz? Didn't Neva call you Jasmine?
Neva's the only one who calls me that, amongst other things. To you and everyone else, it's just plain old Jazz.
Oh, someone else said Jazz, that's right. Sorry about that. What's the deal with you and Neva?
Neva's mine, so don't be getting any ideas.
Oh, I don't.
She may be a little rough around the edges, but she's just looking out for her own. There's no one better to have your back.
Yeah, I don't tend to be interested in people who, you know, threaten my demise every 5 minutes, so you're safe. The fleet has a wider variety. Nope, the fleet has a wider variety than the UC and Freestar Collective.
It may not be wider, but it's not on the books, if that's what you're getting at. I can guarantee your ship will be in good hands. So if you're looking for an upgrade, let me know. We got the best selection in the settled systems. Illegal, unregistered, recalled. We sell it all. No questions asked.
Okay. Will these parts show up on UC or Freestar security scanners?
No. You buy from me, you're worry-free.
That rhymes.
I can't have my customers getting caught now, can I? That's bad for business.
Okay. I'm always looking for an edge.
Anything that keeps the UC and Freestar Rangers off your tail is a must-have in my book. Just let me know when you want to talk business.
How did you wind up on the key?
Truth is, the fleet rescued me. Of course, I wouldn't have needed rescuing if they hadn't blown up the ship I was working on. Delgado plucked me out of space and brought me to the key. I took one look at the place and was compelled to work. Soon after, he offered me a permanent spot with the fleet.
Okay. I'm not gonna keep asking about her and Neva. That's kinda weird.
All business and no fun, huh? What do you need?
My ship needs some repairs. Oh, it might. Alright, yeah. Need some repairs, I think.
I'd love to take your money, but your ship's in perfect condition.
Okay, good. Let me see what ships you have for sale.
Shop's always open, as long as your money's good.
Did you just, like, station outside the, like, attached to the starport, space station, whatever? Crimson Fleet Phantom. See, that's the only problem. I'll be flying around in a Crimson Fleet ship. That's only asking for trouble. Crimson Fleet Haunt and Ghost. Yeah, I don't want to buy their ships. I don't think that would be in my best interest.
We may not have official security on the key, but we're always looking out for traitors.
I wouldn't know any traitors, no. So I did take the liberty of looking around in here, and all she's got is this computer. So I haven't messed with anything. That doesn't work. Let's see what her computer's about. Grease monkeys. Del wanted to know... Did I read this? Del wanted to know if I needed a few extra grease monkeys to help maintain things around here. I told him any more would just get in my way. I don't mean to sound arrogant, and I know my bandwidth is thin, but no one else can do what I do. I don't trust the new mechanic to understand how we've kept this station together with vacuum tape and baling wire. There's just too much tribal knowledge. The same goes for the ships. You know, I think I have been in here. She wasn't here at the time. I read this, yeah, the raisin there or whatever, I remember trying to pronounce that. Okay. Alright, let me go find this thing. This last interview segment.
I want to play again. Ping pong table. You and me. 3 hours. rob you and take your creds.
No, you can't.
Well, I sure told him.
Ask Jazz about any ship upgrades. Nothing worse than a pirate ship with no personality.
Yeah, like you, huh? Steal people's creds. I haven't been in here, I don't think. The key, the last Nova, says it's a bar. Yeah, I have not been in here. Maybe that last interview segment is in here, that would explain it. That's a levitating desk planet. Tempted, but
music
I have so many
of them.
Assaulter. Boggs, Grog. Combat knife. That's a good value. Can I just take that?
So there I am. You see security on my tail? And my
tips.
Grab drive just chokes.
I'm stealing tips.
You know what I find back there? The fattest leech I've ever seen. Worm nearly got me dusted.
Good for you. 171 credits. 165 credits. And 185 credits. I stole from the tip jar. This is what we've come to. Stealing from tip jars. I thought that was sad. Cylindrical glass. Oh, Reckoner's Core. We've been there. A digipack. Thank you very much. Maybe I'll use this on the planet's surface.
Now, you hungry?
Hoka can.
That would make two of us. Need something?
Need something? They're all like dancing down there. Bunch of crazy fools. I can't.
I've got bounties in every system. Idiots will never catch me.
I just gotta get rid of this before I head back to UC space, whatever.
Ugh. Got mixed feelings about my last job.
Good for you.
Well, isn't this cozy? It appears we've stumbled across the embodiment of the phrase absolute mayhem.
Yeah, something like that. At least they have plants. All the comforts of home.
Okay. That last job didn't pan out. I need something bigger.
Bigger? Digitex. Nice. It pays to look around for stuff. I like the music. I'm trying to place what it sounds like to me.
What are you looking at?
Your buttocks.
I'm gonna toast to an old friend thing. One of the best pirates I ever knew.
There it is.
Certainly.
I'm gonna listen to it all in order. Later. A lot of bog frogs.
Everyone's going to
Soon. Soonish. One of these days. What are you talking about? According to issue 4, ballistic weapons permanently do 5% more critical damage. Sweet. Did you pick?
Juan said I ain't allowed to run New Atlantis jobs no more. Those are some of the best profits.
Gotta make sure to train every day. Bad aim and bad health.
All I did was try to get all those extra credits on the side. I didn't think a few more crates in the hold would make that big a difference.
Waste one of the first signs of a problem. If those numbers don't match up, the security be all over you.
Yeah, lesson learned.
Oh, there's a computer here. Calibrated Kraken. Oh, I can take that. And the ammo. Thank you very much. Alright, let's check out the computer. Drinks. Some of the mates have been complaining about watered down drinks, like it's my fault we're serving this piss. Not my fault they haven't been putting in the work to keep us supplied the way we should be. Maybe they should spend less time hanging at the bar and more at the mission boards. Rats. Nava's on edge lately. Part of it is vouching for Rake, but she's been burned before. What's bloody changed is the timing. We're spread thinner than Marmite right now. What's Marmite? And the whole crew knows it. Maybe this new rook will pan out, but if things keep going bad, it's going to be like rats leaving a sinking ship. Who's Rake? Well, that's interesting.
Shot a few bullseyes at the ranch today.
Let's see if there's any named people besides.
The fleet is family. Stealing from each other is just what you call a professional courtesy.
Besides Bog.
Sharks are too scared to take the key.
Oh, Jessamine? There's Jessamine.
Captain's got better up the ranks.
Better perks.
Captain someday.
I'll talk to Jessamine and then the bartender.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's my plan.
Are you looking to start something? Because I'll finish it.
I'll finish it. Oh, yeah. I'll finish it. I'll start and finish it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. Jessamine. Getting up. Back here. Speak.
Hey, Cap. You hiring? Got some baddies on my tail, and I need a place to lay low.
Oh, she's a hireable person. Why are you being tailed?
I'm a smuggler. Making enemies comes with a job. This time, I got in over my head and made one who's more dangerous than me.
Well, it depends who's after you. I'm not interested in making enemies.
I suppose I can't rightly blame you for that. It's the Varun zealots. Been on my tail a while. They're easy enough to avoid in places like this, but I'm history if they see my ship cruising around the space lanes again.
Who are the Varun zealots? I do know a little bit about House Varun, and by that, almost nothing.
They're a group of cultists who operate on the edges of known space. Real nut jobs. They shoot at just about anyone who comes near them. Big on grudges too. That's how I ended up on their radar.
I'm not hiring her yet. I'm just curious what she might have to say. I don't hire just anyone. What kinds of skills do you have? Let me guess. She's good at thievery, ballistic weapon systems, and concealment.
Oh, I'm a real scrapper.
Oh, scrapper
good
too.
Good in a fist fighter in the gunner seat. Doesn't matter to me so long as there's a strong drink waiting when the fight's over. I've also got pretty sticky fingers, if that suits you.
Alright. Not this time, sorry.
Hard to believe what passes for polite conversation these days.
Jeez. Don't get yourself in a tizzy.
I used to work for Microcore. More maybe soon.
Alright, let's talk to Bog. Bog Standard.
I was wondering when you'd wander my way.
You've been wandering.
The name's Fergus. Fergus Wickham.
Oh.
But you can call me Bog. Welcome to the Last Nova, where the drinks are never free.
Why would they be? I'm being moved. So you the bartender here?
Guilty? You name it, I got it. Although, I can't speak to quality. We don't believe in expiration dates here as long as it gets the job done.
How'd you get the name Bog?
Got it back in my experimental days. Before we fixed up Nova, she was a real boggy mess. Practically an indoor swamp. I figured some of what's growing around here could make some decent booze. Some might say I only got the booze part right.
Okay. Well, I just came here for a drink.
Well, then you've come to the right place, mate. Since it's your first time with us, I'm willing to make an exception to the rule and offer you my speciality on the house.
Oh, so you lied then.
One free bottle of Bog's Grog.
It is free. Yeah, I'll take anything that's free.
Well, can't complain, right? And if you like it, you're in luck. Cheapest drink you can find, and guaranteed to drown those sorrows.
What's in your Bog's Grog?
Now that's a trade secret, mate. And a homegrown one at that. But nothing to worry about. I've been serving it up going on 20 years now.
What kind of alcohol?
Only things that kill my customers are bullets and stupidity.
What kind of alcohol is it, though? You can't even tell me that. What can you tell me about the last Nova?
Nova wasn't always the lovely sight you see before you. She used to be a hydro farm and put up quite a fight when we decided to give her a makeover. Overgrown water everywhere. I almost gave up, but what's a proper home without a pub, eh?
Yeah, they're listening to the music. I mean, the vocals sound like black metal, but... I mean, it might be black metal. This sounds like a cross.
Most customers don't ever want to shut up.
That sounds like a cross between Atheist and Obituary, maybe. So what's on the menu?
Yeah, we got the usual suspects.
We got aid and ammo for a shotgun that I don't use. Bourbon. Okay, so Bog's Grog says rum diluted with water. Okay, with a twist of lemon and just a pinch of gunpowder. Okay, so now we know what he puts in it. He wouldn't say, but I guess we're able to analyze it. Patty melt. Chip potatoes. Okay. Thank you very much.
Last Nova never closes, so come back anytime.
Alrighty then.
Every captain here has earned their stripes, bleeding for the fleet.
Marketplace.
Visiting with the Crimson Fleet, eh? Always a pleasure.
That we were.
What are you standing around for? There's work to be done.
Do you know what work needs to be done?
Ready to make those credits? Be seeing you.
You check out the Reckoner's Corps. She's a beaut, ain't she?
I just walk by and talk to the guy.
Are you looking to start something? Shit.
They're always saying that.
Nothing like the smell of a dead shark.
stay here. No, you stay in here. Alright, so what we're going to do for the remainder of this episode, so in case you guys want to tune out, I'm going to listen to all these interview things all in order so we can make some sense out of it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7, which is the final. So I'm probably just going to turn my mic off, I'm going to listen to it, and I might say something about it, or maybe not. I don't know. Listen to all of them except 5, so we'll see, but we'll listen to them in order, and if you guys want to tune out now, then you feel free to do so. But yeah, this is going to take a little while because the interviews are about maybe 2-3 minutes long each, I'm guessing. Alright, so if I don't speak again, see you guys in the next episode. Always seek adventure, and here's our SSNN Kryx interview.
Hello, everyone. I'm Gail Dunnigan of SSNN, and this is Galact Talk. My guest tonight is one of the most notorious criminals in the settled systems. His ruthlessness and desire for wealth has landed him squarely at the top of the wanted list for every major law enforcement agency in the galaxy. I am, of course, speaking of the self-appointed leader of the Crimson Fleet himself, Jasper Kryx. Good evening, Mr. Kryx.
Good evening, Gail. Thank you for accepting my invitation.
Yes, well, being blindfolded and then grav-jumped to what appears to be an abandoned mining facility isn't exactly what I call an invitation.
Well, I'm sure you're not surprised that your request for an interview would come with some very specific conditions.
Frankly, I was a bit surprised to receive any type of response at all. Would you mind telling me why you decided to do this interview?
Because there comes a time in every pirate's life where they have to make an extremely important decision. Do they take a leap and become one of the most legendary pirates in history? Or do they simply sputter on, subsisting on freighters and deep space privateers?
So are we to assume that you are taking the leap? That Jasper Kryx is moving on to bigger and better things in his life?
That's spot on, Gail. That's exactly why you're here.
Interesting. Well then, would you mind sharing with us exactly what your particular leap entails?
In due time. There's no rush. In fact, I'd say we have at least 12 hours before the authorities trace this broadcast. Plenty of time to discuss whatever you like.
Oh. All right then. Perhaps the best place to start this interview would be at the beginning of your career.
Please, proceed.
Where did your stellar rise to infamy begin?
In the streets of New Atlantis. No parents, no godparents. Just a homeless punk kid robbing whoever he could for the credits.
Were these violent crimes? Murders?
I'm a bit offended you even asked that question, Gail. Sure, a few people here and there walked away with injuries, but I'm not some kind of butcher.
That doesn't sound as heartless as your reputation would imply.
Well, like I said, I was just a kid.
Were you ever caught by the authorities in New Atlantis?
Oh, dozens of times. But I'd just give them a fake name, or they just slap me on the wrist and send me on my way. They obviously didn't think that I'd amount to anything and didn't want to waste their time with rehabilitation.
What changed that? Was it the robbery in 2218?
2218? Hmm. Oh, yeah. The Galbank archives. Very good, Gail. See, you've done your research. That would be when I rounded up a few of my buddies and we knocked the place over. Made off with a ton of credits. My first big score.
Is that why the Crimson Scar decided to bring you into their ranks?
That's right. They brought me in, taught me the ropes, and I did crimes for them for 5 years, till I decided I wanted more. I got rid of their leader, put myself in his place, and started running the show. I've been the one in charge ever since.
Was it absolutely necessary to cut his throat and leave the body on a public street in the well?
On the street, reputation is everything. I wanted everyone in the city to know that Jasper Kryx was taken over. I think they got the message.
So, tell us about Jasper Kryx's version of the Crimson Scar.
All I can tell you is that under my guidance, the Crimson Scar became more influential than every other syndicate combined. Here I was, 22 years old, and I had power, people that followed my orders, and an endless stream of credits. Gale, I have to tell you, I was having the time of my life.
So you'd consider extortion, robbery, burglary, kidnapping, assault, and murder to be positive life influences?
No. I'd consider them as just means to an end. Those so-called crimes were merely stepping stones until I had enough wealth to buy the Crimson Scar a few spacecraft.
Yes, let's talk about that. It appears you weren't satisfied with terrorizing New Atlantis alone.
Oh, I've never stopped reaching, Gale. The amount of money we were making in New Atlantis was decent, but the really big scores were in space and the cargo ships. We're talking millions of credits, maybe more. Who the hell could count it all?
Most people assume this is when the UC decided to actively set up a task force to pursue the Crimson Scar.
That's correct. Those idiots in charge of the United Colonies were clearly embarrassed that they had allowed the Crimson Scar to make the jump into space. They sent ships after us. Lots of ships. I almost think that they enjoy starting wars.
Perhaps this was the first time you had finally reached too far.
You could say that. I count my time running the Crimson Scar as a learning experience. I wouldn't say I reached too far. I'd say I reached too fast. Didn't cover all my bases. Made some stupid mistakes. One thing's for certain, though. When I was finally rested and thrown into the lock, I had plenty to think about.
Tell us about your arrest.
Oh, my arrest was spectacular. Definitely one for the record books. UC security sent an armada after our little fleet of ships and picked us off one by one until the remainder of us made it to the wheel.
For a listener's benefit, that was the star station in orbit around Voli that you destroyed just before your arrest, correct?
You see, that's what they'd have you believe, but the truth is much less sinister. There was a firefight on the wheel when they tried to bring us in. We hold up, but UC security unleashed hell. The damage they caused was catastrophic. We only surrendered so we wouldn't die when the station exploded.
Well, the UC says you set demolition charges to try and cover your tracks and make your escape.
That's their story. You'll have to go with your gut on what you think really happened. Anyway, they took us in and tossed us into the lock. That lovely resort they opened on Suvorov.
And you were imprisoned there for how long?
Well, it was supposed to be for life, Gale. But I ended up serving 2 years before I decided I'd had enough.
Is there any particular reason that you started the riots that eventually led to the worst prison break in United Colonies history?
Yes. I'm quite proud of that, actually. I honestly didn't think it would go as well as it did. As for the reason, well, it's simple. The UC were treating us like animals. The conditions in the lock were ridiculously bad and no one cared. That's why they stuck us on that ice ball in the first place. Out of sight, out of mind.
Your escape caused the deaths of many that were stationed at the lock. Some would brand that as a bit dismissive for what you're describing as a protest. If you were simply advocating for your fellow inmates, why didn't you just go through the proper channels?
And what the hell was I supposed to do? Send a strongly worded letter to my duly appointed representative? Wake up. The UC only responds to actions, not words. In my mind, there was no other choice. You know what? Let's move past my time at the lock so we can get to the point of this goddamned interview.
Certainly. Let's talk about something else. How did the Crimson Scar become the Crimson Fleet?
After I busted out of the lock, I decided to take things to the next level. I had the key, a few UC ships, and a couple dozen ex-cons at my side. But I needed more, so I sent out the call. Once word got around, it didn't take long for freelance pirates from every corner of the settled systems to show up.
And this is how the Crimson Fleet was born.
Exactly. The key became our base of operations. We spent months reinforcing our position there, making it nearly impossible to approach.
What was the UC's response to the situation?
First of all, UC security gave up and handed the reins over to the big guns, the UC Navy. The Navy, in turn, sent ships to attack the key. I'd say there have been three major attacks over the last few years. And as you can tell by the fact we're having this interview, all the attacks were embarrassing failures.
Do you feel these embarrassing failures led them to form UC Systeth?
Absolutely. They've clearly given up and decided to shove the responsibility onto a separate division. That way, in the public eye, the UC Navy can move forward, proud and strong, while UC Systeth continually takes all the blame. It's all about PR spin for them, Gale. That's how the UC operates. Kinda disgusting, don't you think?
Sounds a bit like you're trying to deflect attention off the atrocities the Crimson Fleet commits on a daily basis.
Atrocities, huh? How about fighting the Free Star Collective over a bunch of rocks hanging in space? How about thousands of people dying while a bunch of pencil-pushing bastards sit in a cushy office and draw lines on a star map? Maybe the United Colonies should stop the bullshit and take a hard look in the mirror to see who the monsters really are.
Tell us what the future holds for the Crimson Fleet.
Changes are coming, Gale. Huge changes. Crimson Fleet will soon be a much bigger player in this little game between the members of the settled systems.
That's quite a bold statement. Would you care to elaborate?
Well, let's just say that I'm on the brink of a score so large, it makes everything else pale in comparison. Beyond that, the others have to wait and see.
If you aren't willing to discuss the details, why grant SSNN this interview?
Simple. I refuse to allow the UC to spin or bury the story, making it sound like they're in complete control of the situation. I'm gonna tell you right now, they aren't.
Why does the Crimson Fleet need to make this mysterious move that you're being so evasive about?
I know Systeth instructed you to draw this meeting out as long as possible. So let me sum this up. I intend to make sure that the Crimson Fleet becomes the United Colonies' worst nightmare. And nothing, I mean nothing in this universe, will stop me from achieving that goal.
There are those that would disagree with you and claim this interview is grandstanding, or worse, a recruitment tool. After all, SSNN reaches every corner of the settled systems, and your aspirations could inspire the directionless to turn to the fleet.
You and the sheep that listen to your garbage can believe whatever the hell you want. If you were so worried about what I had to say, you wouldn't have allowed yourself to be brought here.
Let me just ask you one final question before we wrap up.
Fine. Go ahead.
When is enough going to be enough? How many credits does Jasper Kryx need until he's satisfied?
I should have expected you'd ask such a stupid question. How the hell could you ever understand? You with your fancy education, and your sheltered upbringing, and your cushy media job? Me? I came from nothing. Everything I own, I've literally drawn blood to gain.
There's no need to get personal. I'm simply trying to state the facts so that our listeners can make judgments of their own.
Lady, I got news for you. Half of your listeners think I'm a hero. The other half are scared out of their goddamn minds. And they should be.
Perhaps we should talk about something else.
No, that's it. We're done. Can you guys get her the hell out of here? Make sure she takes all the sound equipment with her.
Well, that's it then. Thank you for your...
Actually, before you go, Gail, there's one more thing I would like to say.
Yes, of course. What is it?
When you broadcast this interview on SSNN, I want you to remember that I'll be listening. If you edit even one word or manipulate my voice to change anything I've said, I will hunt you down and kill you in front of everyone. Do you understand?
I understand. You have my word.